Dear children, as we have already dealt with the chapter Emotional Maturity from Value Education of Joyful Living, today we are going to deal with the certain questions from that chapter. Okay, so that you can understand the chapter better and have a recap of the entire chapter through the questions. Now, the very first important question that we need to understand is, what is emotional maturity? Isn't it, girls? That is really, really important to know and to understand. That what in life or what in a human being is emotional maturity? I'll be giving you an example of it so that you can understand the lines better. Now, when we think of someone who's emotionally mature, girls, we typically picture a person who has a good understanding of who they are. Okay? They really know that this is what I want in life. This is what I want to be in life. So they are very clear about certain things in their own life and have a very good understanding of who they are. In other words, you can say that emotional maturity is when someone can manage their emotions no matter their circumstances is. This is very important. When we are emotionally disbalanced, right, girls? We many a times lose our temper, go into a tremendous rage and feel like taking revenge on someone. It depends from person to person. We lose our cool. We lose our calmness in ourselves. It is very essential to control yourself right at that moment. No matter what the surrounding is, no matter what the situation is around you. So, in other words, you can say that a person who can tackle his or her life, remaining cool, calm to the disturbance caused by other situations around her, that person is very, very emotionally matured. You may find in the class that your best friend all of a sudden starts crying over something. She loses herself. She cannot express herself that what her problem is. She doesn't understand how to tackle her problem or how to overcome that problem. And you, on the other hand, you give her suggestions, you give her advice that this can also be controlled. It's nothing like hell. We can always overcome our problems if we take it step by step. So, isn't it that you are much more emotionally mature than your friend being of the same age? Isn't it, girls? Because you know that there is a solution to every problem in life. There is a solution to every failure in life. Failures are a part and parcel of life that will remain in everybody's life. You may be a student, you may be a working woman, you may be a mother, you may be a wife to someone. So there will be problems in life. But how to manage that? How to overcome that? That reveals your emotional maturity. So a person who can deal with these things very nicely is really emotionally matured. They know how to respond to tough situations and still keep their cool. You have your final examination just before yourself, okay? And you crumble under that stress and pressure. Oh my God, how am I going to do well in the examination? What will happen if I do not score marks? What will my parents tell me? What are my friends going to think about me if I do not score good marks? So these are the various stress, girls, that you are taking upon yourself. You needn't do that. But somehow you are suppressed and you go deep into that tough situation. Someone else, that person is also will also be sitting for the examination, but she knows that, okay, fine, I may not do well in this examination, I may not do well in the next examination, but I will do in the third one. So this very willpower in yourself helps you to respond to the tough situation. And you can remain calm in these situations. Now, for example, being able to have a rational conversation with your significant other when you disagree. It's not necessary, girls, that every opinion of yours will be as same as your friend's. Right? It will differ. Human beings do differ on varied opinions, with varied opinions. So, but you can have a rational conversation with the other person when you disagree, rather than going into an argument, going into a terrible fight, throwing things here and there, instead of ranting and raving. You can talk to each other. You can justify yourself to other, and so can the other person, and that can be really sorted out. So this is known as emotional maturity. We move on to the second question, girls, that what are the characteristics of emotional maturity? Number one, self-awareness, very much needed. The second thing is self-control over your own thoughts and over your own self, right? And accountability, humility, self-acceptance that yes, I have done this wrong, to accept that fact that this was my mistake, so I'm sorry, to apologize to someone. Is a very noble deed, girls. Many a times our ego doesn't allow us to do that. So, gratitude, expressing your gratitude to someone who really, really is there for you. Compassion and being other-centered. Other-centered means only not catering of thinking to your own self. You in life also know how to think about others. If a girl in your class is very weak in maths and you are scoring the highest marks in the class in maths, so rather being selfish and just thinking, oh, I'm just scoring so high marks and the teachers are praising me, my friends are praising me for my marks, rather than doing that, won't it be really good to just move forward and help that other girl to be a good mathematician? So that is that you are being other-centered. So these are the various characteristics one has in oneself that can prove that yes, the person is really, really emotionally matured. The third question, girls, is how do you develop emotional maturity? Now, this can also be developed, right? Every person born is not matured, girls. Every person at a certain stage is like, if you are 14 years age, it's not necessary that you will be emotionally matured. No. A guy can be matured at 14 and another one can be matured at 21. So there can be differences. But you can also develop this in yourself, right? So the step one is, girls, that rehearse reaching your goals. set yourself a goal in life and then you rehearse for that. Step 2, daily affirmations. Keep your eye on the prize. This is what I want to achieve in life. This is my mission in life. So set your focus on that. Your eye means your focus on that. Step 3, set healthy boundaries, girls. This is very, very important. If you have your environment completely negative, that is surely bound to affect you. So try to stay happy, try to stay cool, try to enjoy your life rather than crumbling yourself under a lot of questions, a lot of disgusting things which make you really, really depressed. The fourth point is learn to pause. This also, a person who runs very fast at times do really get very tired of it. So there should be a pace in what you do. There's no hurry in achieving your goals. Take your time. Take your time, girls. But keep your focus steady. That is the best way you can see. You will find that an athlete on a race course, the person who wins, girls, has a constant speed over there. At the very beginning, it's not that he just runs very fast. And after reaching a certain point, he just slows down his pace. No, it's nothing like that. He just keeps a constant pace of his running. So that helps him to achieve his goal. The fifth point is infuse emotional maturity into your work. Through your work, you can really project your mind, how far you can think, the processing of your mind. So that is very important. And the last one, girls, is behavioral growth. So we'll go to question number 4. What is emotional maturity in relationships? Emotional maturity in relationship is defined by the ability to manage your emotions and take full responsibility of your actions. Right? That I know what I am doing. I can understand what I am doing. I won't be doing things in haste or not thinking rationally or analytically. Not being too emotional and just jump into the thing. No. What I do, my action will speak. So you will be taking full responsibility for your actions. The next one is number 5, girls, is what defines maturity in a person? In psychology, maturity is the ability to respond to the environment, being aware of the correct time and location to behave, and knowing when to act according to the circumstance and the culture of society one lives in. You should be cautious of the fact, okay, this is the time that I should open up and this is the place I should open up. Not necessary that every time you have to be vocal about your opinions in the wrong place. Then you are projecting yourself as a very wrong person. So be very careful about that, girls. What are the signs of maturity in a person? Recognize and admit when you are wrong. Number 1. Recognize and admit that you are not biased. Recognize you have your own feelings and not needs your feelings. Don't run the show. And the other one that I said is, girls, set healthy boundaries. Pause between feeling and reacting. Sometimes we are very happy, we get too excited, and we do a lot of things then. Feel that. Feel into you and then react, then respond. Oh my God, she's done such a good thing, and you just jump to hug that person. No, take your time. Feel it that yes, this person really needs a warm hug. So then go and do it. Love defined as compassion. The seventh question we have here is, how do I change my childish behavior? Sometimes though we grow up, girls, our certain behavior remains very childish. So how can we just change that? One way you can do is to get rid of an immature reputation is simply by acting more mature in life. You are not so, but you act like that. Consider how you think and act around people of your own age and do best to be considerate. Give that person time. Let that person understand that yes, you are taking her seriously and you are listening to that person and thinking about how you can help that person. In social settings, make sure to think before you speak rather than blurting things out. Having conversation over a lot of people, with a lot of people, and then you find, oh, I need to talk. I need to say out things. I need to blurt out things. No. No. Sometimes it is not at all necessary. Listen. And then also you can speak out, girls. Okay? Okay. Question number 8. From emotional maturity, what are the different levels of maturity? Now, people live in one of the 4 states of being which could be considered. We all live in 4 states of being, and that if we know that, we can groom ourselves on that. So, levels of emotional development or maturity, that is, these are survival, fear-based living, security, duty-based living, success, ego-based living, and serenity. That is love-based living. Okay, these are the 4 states of being. One is fear-based living. You're in a constant fear. How far can you live life like that, girls? Security, your duty towards the society, towards your parents, towards your brothers and sisters. Success is ego-based living. And serenity, calmness, peacefulness, love-based living. Okay? So, these are the various questions that you can get from the chapter, that is, we have emotional maturity from your value education. We will move on to the next chapter that also we have given you a video of, girls, that is at the crossroads, right? So the first question here, girls, is that is also very important. What do you mean by crossroad in life? Crossroad, we know that. It's a junction where a number of roads are before you and you get very confused to which one should I go into. Now, occasionally we get to a point in our lives where we see the path diverging in front of us. Sometimes it's more dramatic than that. And we find ourselves at a clear crossroad. Parting ways, evident choices, decisions that cannot coexist. That is known as the crossroad of life. Number 2 we have here is, and what do you do when you are in a crossroad in life? Almost each and every one girls, we all face crossroads in our life at one point or the other, where it's very, very tough to take decisions on our own. So when you reach a crossroad in life, don't try to rush through the process. If you can't put off a decision for a bit, if you can't think clearly about it, or if you cannot come to a conclusion or cannot take a decision, leave it for a while. Keep it away for a while. Give yourself that option. You can continue to gather advice and information, but in the meantime, be still. Okay? Moving on to the third question. We have, what does a crossroad in a relationship mean? Crossroad in a relationship means, girls, an opportunity to stop and reflect on your current situation. Think on your current situation. Keep reading to know more about the facts of life. And how can we make a decision? Okay, girls, at a crossroad in life. Now, as I said before, that this is very, very tough. Very tough at times. Now, make the decision based on what you really want in life. You don't make it based on what's easiest in the moment or what has the least risk. Do not do that. Or even what other people expect of you. Now, this is very common, girls. This is very common for children, that every time you ask them that, what do you want to be in your life? My mother wants me to be a doctor. My father wants me to be a doctor. There's so much expectation on your own self that you just go deep down with it. You are burdened with the pressure of it. You feel suffocating right then. Do not take a decision right then. Instead, you do what's right for you and let the consequences follow. What you want in life, you have to know that. So, and that will follow. That will smoothly, you can follow that. Another very important question is that, girls, what are the 5 questions to weigh when you are at a career crossroad? Now, for class 10, girls, this is very important. Think about these questions, girls. This is very important. Think about these various questions. Question number 1. Who will I become if I take this opportunity? Ask yourself these questions. Find out the answers. Question number 2. What do I need to give for this opportunity? Question number 3. What frames are around my options? Question number 4, what sacrifices do I need to make if I take this opportunity? And the last very important question is, girls, is it worth it to take so much of risk in life, to so give so much in life, to make so much of sacrifices in life? Is it really worth it? So think about these questions when you are really at a career crossroad. My last question to you girls is, why is crossroad a difficult area? Simply because it can cause a lot of perplexity in life, girls. If you are not clear about what you really want in for yourself, it will cause a lot of perplexity in life. Do not do what your parents want you to do. Do not see what your friends are doing. Be focused on what you want in life. Have the right to speak it out to your parents, but you need to have an explanation behind that why you don't want to go in that field or travel through that road to reach your success in life. That has to be clarified. That has to be explained to your parents. So, do not think, oh my God, now what to do? There are so many options right before me. And I'm getting so confused. I'm in such a perplexity that what should I do? Which path should I take? Think about it, girls. Really, A serious thought is the most important thing that you can give it right then. Take your time. Okay? So I think that we have dealt with a very few important questions from both the chapter that is going to help you to understand it once again better and to deal it if you are given questions later on. Okay, guys? So please, please do go through it and try to write the answers, girls. That is very important. Okay, thank you and bye. And bye. And bye.